Hey everybody, it's Kyle Van Voorhis with Voorhis.com, and today we are going to be discussing writing or developing a sales playbook. Yeah, this is a big topic. Let's dive right in. Alrighty, so a sales playbook is a pretty intricate part of a sales organization. And oftentimes a VP of sales or the founder or somebody in marketing will put together a sales playbook so when you're onboarding sales reps and SDRs that there's something you can give them where they can learn everything they need to just get their sea legs about them. And that's what I want to discuss today. I'm going to walk you through a template that we use with our clients to develop sales playbooks that are incredibly scalable, check all of the boxes, and really help with the onboarding process. And you'd be surprised. If you don't have a sales playbook yet, you're not alone. The vast majority of organizations we work with don't have one when we start working with them. So pay attention, take some notes, and if you look in the description, I'll have a link to our template so you can copy and paste it. All right, let's jump in. The first section of your sales playbook is pretty simple. You got to have a company information or overview section. And this is where you start, right? Because if you're a brand new employee, you have to know who's who and what's what. So this is how we do it. We have a section for company overview. And within that section, there's really two key areas. The first one is the organization, the chart, so to speak. Where does everybody fit in? Where, who's the leadership? What departments do they lead, et cetera? And then right after that, communication with managers. I really like, and I forget the kind of the popularization of this, but I really like the idea of having an outline of how you as a manager like to be communicated with. So every manager within the organization, anyone in a leadership role, should outline how they like to be communicated with. So when new sales reps are onboarded, they have access to that kind of information. So they already know going in, hey, I should Slack them, I should email them, things of that nature. And also some fun facts. I don't know. Let's make it a little bit easy to read. All right, the next section of the sales playbook is industry. This is incredibly important because you're gonna put all of the industry information, and that's the industry you serve. So that way, when you have a new sales rep who joins the team, they have a place they can go to learn a little bit about the industry. Not everybody, unless this is part of your hiring plan, not everybody is gonna have that industry expertise. So explaining to them how the industry works, some industry terms, and also the roles of the people you're reaching out to and what they do on a daily basis, not specifically buyer personas, but just what their day looks like, will help give this new rep a lay of the land from an industry perspective, which will help during other conversations make sure that they're up to speed. Real quick, if you're liking the content, please click the like button. It helps us out a ton. Now let's get back to watching the video. The next section of the playbook is product, pricing, and personas, the triple P. That's right. This is the area we're going to talk about the product. What does it do? Then how much do we charge for this thing? And then finally, who are the people that are typically buying and what impact does it have on their workflow or on their life? What problems does it solve? And there's one thing I want to make very clear for this section. When you're outlining the personas and what problem you're solving for that persona, make sure to include how they're trying to solve this problem today. Just because you have a solution to a problem doesn't mean that people are just going to buy it. They are trying to solve it actively already, and they're not just letting a problem exist. If you don't understand how they're trying to solve it and the inefficiencies of that solution, you're not going to be able to sell your solution. So make sure you outline how they're trying to solve that problem today. Alrighty, what's the next part of the playbook? Good question. Sales process and workflow. This is where you're going to outline the high-level sales process and the workflow of the SDRs, the AEs, the sales engineers, whoever's involved in that sales process, what they do on a daily basis. For example, this is where you'll include your outbound prospecting guides, your inbound nurturing plans. Talk about the high level of the discovery, the demo, what's that process look like? What are the typical conversion rates across the sales funnel? Go through what a proposal looks like. How do negotiations go down? These are all important pieces of information so that way a new rep can quickly understand how sales works at your organization. The next step is a pretty big one, and we call it a messaging library. And this is the part of the sales playbook where you include all of the messaging, the sales messaging specifically, that the organization uses. Outbound cold call scripts, inbound scripts, templates for emails, case studies, all of this information should be housed in one place. That way, right from the get-go, someone can read all of that sales information and not only better understand the solution you're providing and how you go about getting that solution in the hands of your target buyer, but what it also does is allow them to get out of the gates a lot quicker because they have all of the messaging. They don't have to go search around for it. It's very simple. It's in one place. Right after the messaging, we go into more operational best practices. So how should you be researching an account? How should you be researching a contact? What are some best practices for a sequence if you're building your own, or do you have predefined sequences that they're gonna be using? Include that stuff there. How should the rep be managing their time? How do they prioritize what they're doing? These are all really important pieces. And finally, in this section, you must outline your technology stack. And this is the part of the sales playbook that's gonna need to be updated the most frequently. As you bring on more sales tools and more resources for the sales team to be successful, you need a place where a rep can see everything they have access to and where it fits within their workflow. If not, they're just gonna lean on things that they're comfortable with and not feel the full value of the tech stack that you have put in place for the team. And finally, at the very end of the sales playbook, this is the best part, the metrics. What are we holding them accountable to? What are the expectations? What are the KPIs that leadership is looking at? And what is your focus as a sales rep, as an SDR? These metrics and having a clear, defined set of KPIs that you're gonna be looking at is imperative for your reps to understand the culture within the organization. Not the, you know, the culture amongst the team, but how we're managing up is incredibly important, and metrics are a big way to do that. A rep must understand how they're evaluated and not just figure it out as they go along. Alrighty, that's it for today, folks. Look, we have an entire guide on the website and a free template. Like, it's all up there. So go read that article if you want even more details on how to outline your sales playbook. And we also give a template that you can copy and paste. No email or anything. It's totally free. So go grab that. Hopefully you've found this helpful. Please like, subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And we will talk soon.